Hey everyone, it's Karolina. I'm a first year pre-biomedical engineering student here at UBC, and today I'm going to be giving you a full breakdown of everything you need to know about first year engineering classes, particularly first semester. Part 2, so second semester of this video, will be linked in the description down below, coming out next week, and there are timestamps in the description that'll give you each class. For each class, I will be breaking down a full overview of what you need to know about the class, as well as a module breakdown that'll be listed on the screen, and all the equivalent high school credits that will get you transfer credits for that class in particular. At the end of this video, I'll be finishing it off with some general advice about how to survive first year classes. While all of the course codes I'm talking about are specific to UBC, they have fairly similar equivalents in all engineering programs across Canada and maybe even in the US. Before we begin, to earn the first year credit from high school equivalents, you're going to need a 4 or higher on your AP exam, you're going to need an A or a B in all A level classes for the British pattern system, and for IB, they're going to look at all higher level courses and some standard level courses with varying scores per class. First off, we have APSCI 100. This is your engineering design course that teaches you how to think like an engineer and what it means to be an engineer. It's divided into 4 modules, each with a team deliverable or project at the end of them, and you will be assigned to a team at the beginning and you'll go through the entire term with them, so make sure to build a good rapport with them and get a good schedule going. You're gonna have a lot of individual prep, team quizzes, and group work to do every week. And so you really have to focus on what they're trying to teach you in terms of the way of thinking instead of just memorizing things, because that's what you're going to be tested on. You also are going to get the chance to work on the cardboard chair project, which we have a longer video that goes more into detail about on our channel. Next up, we have Math 100, which is differential calculus. Depending on if you did calculus in high school or not, it might be a lot of review. For me, it was, with some extra applications of calculus. I would recommend really doing the web work, which is the homework that they assign every week, as that's like basically the main part of the course, and it does give you a good idea of how much you understand for the exams. So before the exams, redo the homework, do the EUS tutoring packages that they give you, and really focus on what you don't understand and do a lot of practice for those concepts. Next, we have PHYS 157, which is Intro to Physics for Engineers, and it's essentially divided into thermodynamics, which is the main part of the course, and then you do some waves at the end. It's a lot of fairly basic concepts that I hadn't learned in the past, but that build off of each other, so it's really important to gain a deep understanding of how all the concepts relate to each other, and the course is focused on how you're problem solving as opposed to just memorizing things. I would really recommend doing the weekly readings, doing the weekly homework assignments, and like keeping up with the course, as well as listen in class, because it's actually really helpful. And then before midterms and exams, understand the concepts and really grasp those really well, and then just do lots and lots of problems. Next up, we have APSCI 160, your coding class. The first half is the software module, in which you're coding in C, and then the second half of the class is using this DAC module, which is specific to UBC and this online virtual software simulation. And so the style of learning for this class is actually flipped classroom, meaning that you watch videos with the lecture content before coming to class that week, and then you go to class and have these quicker questions as well as a worksheet to do, and then afterwards you have a pre-lab and a lab to do for that week. If you do the pre-lab, you're going to be set for the lab because it's actually quite a bit more difficult generally. And then overall, it's really important for you to have a good understanding, a good foundation starting at the beginning, even when you think, oh, it might be easy, because the concepts really, really build off of one another. Next up, we have PHYS 170, which is your Intro to Mechanics course. It's divided into statics and dynamics, and as a whole, the course is really just applications of simple math. It's not too difficult to grasp, and once you do get it, it's just a question of practice. If you are stuck on a certain concept though, or a certain type of question, it's really important to go read the textbook. It's a really, really good resource for this course. And then also, there are so many videos on YouTube that you can watch detailing how you go through every single step for all the different types of problems. For the exams, the questions are actually fairly similar to textbook questions, so if you practice, you'll be set. Next up, we have Words 150, which is academic rating. You can also take specific English equivalents in first year. A lot of people take this course first, second semester, or even during the summer. And I found a lot of my friends did have transfer credits from high school for this one. But I did find my course interesting and actually quite applicable for writing papers later on, as that's the main bulk of the course, is reading academic writing and then actually applying it and writing it yourself. It's really gonna vary based on the topic and the prof that you have. I had an amazing prof and my topic was really interesting, as it was the constructions and implications of race. So the topics of all of your research papers you're going to be reading and writing will be about that topic. So make sure to check out the list that's posted on the website and choose a topic that interests you. CHEM 154 is chemistry for engineers. And so if you're outside of the PBME timetable, you will be taking it. Therefore, why I didn't take it, but all of my friends did. And so essentially it's a condensed version of chemistry for engineers. So it's quite a bit simpler than the one for science students or pre-biomedical students, and the lab component is the part that's a lot more difficult. But as a whole, the course is not too terrible. If you do the problems and you do listen in class, then you should be okay. Chem 121 or Chem 120 is the chem course that most science students actually take in first semester. And so if you're in the PBME like I was, then that means that you will be taking this course first term. It's actually, for me, it was a lot of review from high school. It's structure and bonding chemistry. And so it's looking at a lot of topics that if you took IB Chem, that's what you looked at in both grade 11 and grade 12. I would say the main focus of this course would really just be do the textbook readings before class and do the weekly assignments and you should be okay. But if you are stuck on certain concepts, really take the time to study those, not just right before the midterms. To wrap up, surviving and thriving in first year is 100% possible. You are capable of doing so, but it is important to recognize that everyone gets lost sometimes. It's a very normal occurrence. And so when this does happen, try to read a textbook, go to office hours, reach out to a friend, or watch a YouTube video, as it's really important to try not to get stuck on something and instead go back to it later, leave it alone, and work on something else instead of like spending several hours just working on that one problem. And as a whole, try to keep up with your classes, with the readings, assignments, and everything like that. You are 100% capable of getting through this. I believe in you. Thank you so much for watching. Leave any questions you have in the comments down below, and good luck on first year.